Tennessee and Georgia as the Bulldogs leave the field. That's the roar you hear in the background. Back to their dressing room down to your right. And both teams come into the game with records of 5-2. Tennessee losing to Auburn and to Alabama. Georgia has lost to Tulane and Alabama. Alabama the only common foe for these two schools. And in that game, Tennessee lost by a score of 17-10. And Georgia lost to Alabama by a score of 25-7. It's the 15th meeting of the two schools. Tennessee has an edge by one game, 7-6-1. This is John Ward with Bill Anderson. I'll be sending you the action of this game. This afternoon, Tennessee is playing Georgia here at Sanford Stadium, a beautiful stadium. You've heard the term between the hedges, and it's explained by the fact that in front of the stadium on either side, there is a hedge, the length of the football field. It's a grass surface, a beautiful field, a beautiful stadium. It's open. We're actually out with the fans, so there'll be a lot of noise behind us. Bill Anderson is here, and he's been studying the films and reviewing these two squads. And Bill, I think probably you could say that we are seeing two teams with almost unbelievably similar records.
That's true, John. I think people say, how is this ball game going to come out? And I think if you wanted to try to compare, this is the most even team, on paper at least, that Tennessee's faced all year. It's amazing how close things are. We look at the Tennessee offense. We rushed 330 times for 1,240 yards. Georgia's rushed 368 times for 1,249 yards. Tennessee's pass were 833. Georgia's pass were 882. Total offense, 2,073 yards. Georgia's total offense, 2,131. I don't know how you're going to get it any closer than that.
And to carry it a step further, I don't know whether you gave the minus yardage, which in most cases would be a quarterback being thrown for a loss, but that too is very similar.
Yeah, I think it's about 230 yards per quarterback, and so they're just as evenly matched, I think, as you could possibly get. Of course, both teams are tough on defense, and it should develop to probably one of the best games that we've seen this year.
All right, Bill, we hear this phrase used quite often. I'm going to ask you a question. Perhaps you can explain it to us. That we hear people say, we've got to establish the running game, which I assume means establish the running game to set up the passing game. But tell us, what is it possible to establish a passing game to start off?
Yeah, I think that's true. Of course, different coaches have different philosophies. And I think Dooley, from all the pass teams he's had, his basic philosophy of the game is to establish a running game. Go with the running game, a good, strong running game, and then throw the ball. Of course, you can't just, I think that's what makes the passing game go, is to have a good, strong running game, because the defense has to come up in there, play you tight, and they get to concentrating on that running game, and all of a sudden, bang, they hit you with a big pass, just like Alabama. It's pretty much the same kind of philosophy. I've never really seen anybody go with a strictly offensive passing game without having a pretty good running game and be successful. Now, I don't know why that is, but I think you can defend. If you're not going to run the football, you get all the defensive linemen, linebackers coming at you, and they just unload and come after the quarterback, and it makes it awfully tough if you don't have that running game in there to hold them at home so you can pass protect and then throw the football.
Well, you mentioned also earlier the fact that Georgia's defense, Tennessee basically a four-man defense, Georgia five-man, which is designed, I assume, as you mentioned, more against the run, although Georgia's defensive secondary, particularly in its game against Vanderbilt, in which it intercepted four passes, does a great job defensively against the passing game.
Well, I think Georgia's philosophy is a little bit different. Possibly, you know, we used to see a 5-3. That was the normal. When they put the five men down, they would have the three linebackers in there, and then they'd go with the three deep zones. But the way schools are throwing the ball now, you've got just about have to have four people back there so you can play the pass, rotate into the zones, and do the different combinations that they do. So what Georgia has done is put the five men down. They sacrifice one linebacker, and they go with the two linebackers, and that gives them the full strength that anybody would have in the secondary.
Georgia is coached by Vince Dooley, as we mentioned. His assistant coaches, Erskine Russell, Frank Inman, Jim Hyburn, Sam Mervoris, Howard Ayers, Mike Astronis, Bird Wiggum, John Donaldson, Jimmy Vickers, John Cassay, Barry Wilson, and Pat Hodgkins. Tennessee's head football coach is Bill Battle. Heading up the offense is Jim Wright, assisted by Ray Trail and Lyde Huggins. Defense, Lon Hurstman, Jerry Elliott, and Gary Wyant. Georgia, Sanford Stadium, Athens, Georgia. Let's take a look now at the probable starting lineup for Georgia on offense to acquaint you with some of the names. The split in Rex Putnell, 6'3", 176, a senior from Macon, Georgia. The tight end is Lynn Honeycutt, 6'2", 205, senior from Rome, Georgia. The offensive forward wall, Jim Currington had one tackle, 6'3", 228. The other tackle is Barry Collier, 6'5", 264. The guards are Mac McWhirter, 6'2", 218, and Jim McPitskin, 6'2", 232. The center, Chris Hammond, 6'1", 225. In the backfield, at quarterback is Andy Johnson, 6'1", 198, a junior from Athens, Georgia. The fullback is Robert Honeycutt, 6'2", 213, senior from Greenville, South Carolina. The tailback will be either Jimmy Poulos, who is 5'11", 183, a junior from Atlanta, or Hal Bissell, 5'11", 177, a junior from Birmingham, Alabama. The wide receiver is scheduled to be Bob Byrne, 6'3", 200, a junior from Tampa, Florida. Horace King will also be used as a flanker. And looking back at the split-in position, Jim Harper and David Christensen both will see action. So your six key positions to keep in mind include the names Putnell, Harper, Christensen, King, and Burns as split receivers. Burns could also play as a tight end. Honeycutt can be a tight end. The quarterback is Johnson. The running back, Honeycutt, Poulos, Bissell, possibly Donnie Allen, who is Honeycutt's substitute at fullback. Number two quarterback who has played quite a bit this year is James Ray. On defense for Georgia, the forward wall has it in Tommy Smoke. He's 6'2", 193, a junior from Savannah. Actually, they go with only one end as far as their designation is concerned. And then two tackles, a strong and weak tackle. Milton Bruce is a tackle at 6'4", 224. And Dennis Hester at 6'3", 217. The guards are Jim Cagle at 6'5", 235. And Dan Jones at 6'2", 225. The linebackers, George Pilcher, 6'1", 204. Keith Harris, 6'1", 190. The corners are Gene Swinford, 5'11", 176. And Larry West, 5'11", 190. Here come the Volunteers of Tennessee racing onto the field. Tennessee wearing white jerseys with orange numerals. The safety for Georgia, Dick Kahn, 6'1", 176. Jerome Jackson, 6'1", 185. Now for Tennessee on offense, as we have it, the ends split in Emmon Love, 6'2", 190, a junior, from Oak Ridge, Tennessee. Sonny Leach, 6'2", 205, a senior from Raleigh, North Carolina. As the Georgia team is preparing to race onto the field, and that's the roar you hear in the background. And this is a very active crowd, and we're sitting right in the middle of it. So that the crowd noise is going to be very, very heavy for this contest here at Sanford Stadium. Now here come the Georgia Bulldogs onto the field. The offensive line for Tennessee, the tackles will be Gene Fillion, 6'5", 215, a junior from Tampa, Florida. David Schaefer, 6'4", 225, a junior from Oak Ridge. The guards are Galen Hill, 6'3", 235, from Brownsville. Bill Emmendorfer, 6'2", 220, from Cleveland. The center is scheduled to be Steve Urobeck, 6'2", 225, a junior from Chicago. In the backfield for Tennessee, quarterback Condre Conaway, 5'11", 175, sophomore, Huntsville, Alabama. Fullback Bill Rutter, 6'2", 220, junior, Winchester, Tennessee. Tailback Haskell Standback, 6'2", 200, junior, from Kannapolis, North Carolina. And the wingback or flanker is Chip Howard, 6'2", 170, a junior from Knoxville, Tennessee. To kick off, it will be Townsend kicking off. Deep for Georgia will go Horace King and Steve White standing back at the goal line. Here is Townsend from Dalton, Georgia. High kick, deep in the end zone. 9 yards deep, he's going to bounce. And so it will be. Georgia's ball, first down at 10 to go at the 20-yard line as Townsend, with the wind, knocks it deep into the end zone. 70 degrees at high. Wide out to the left side comes Harper as the split receiver. Johnson gives it to Bissell up the middle to the 22 to the 23-yard line. Backed up in the middle of the line for Tennessee. John Wagner and Art Reynolds were there on the tackle. Defensively, Tennessee has Lambert at 6'3", 190 from Jacksonville at one end. Johnson, 6'2", 220 at Fellows. The corners are Graham and Allen. The safeties, Pound, and back there with him, Brown. Here comes Andy Johnson. Spread out left to the 25, to the 26, to the 27, onto the 28 or 9-yard line. He's met as he gets forward to the 29 by Eddie Wilson, who came up to cover, along with Tim Pound. It's short of a first down by 2 yards as they spot it a little shy, just past the 28-yard line. Andy Johnson behind three men who were out leading the interference on a sweep of the end. He's a fine running quarterback. Third down, Tennessee in a four-man front. Linebacker stunning. Quarterback is Andy Johnson. Long count. Pitches the ball to Bissell. Bissell for the first down, past the 30, to the 31, on to the 32, where he is submarined by Art Reynolds. But Georgia moves for the first down, and they have run Bill Anderson to the same side on the first three plays, coming to the close side.
That's right. One, of course, I think the first one was pretty much up the middle, but they do what they like to do best. They just power.
Georgia, first down, 10 to go. No score, first quarter. Just getting underway. Gives to the fullback, and he is stopped. Tennessee spelled the play, and they stunned the linebackers right up there into the gap, waiting for Robert Honeycutt, who crunched from the 32 to the 32-and-a-half. Art Reynolds and Jamie Rotella, the linebackers who were plugging that middle, were there to make it. They go to the wishbone with Honeycutt and Bissell as the running back. Here's the give to the second man through, and tripping forward is Bissell past the 33-yard line to the 34, and he falls at the 35, upended there by Fulgham of Tennessee. As Georgia runs from the wishbone, Honeycutt, Bissell, and Bob Burns were on third down, 6 yards to go. Harper, quarterback is Johnson, back to throw, waiting in the pocket, looking downfield, pass dropped at the 40-yard line by the flaring Bissell. He was free at the 40 and would have had a first down, but he dropped the ball. So it becomes fourth down and 6 yards to go for Georgia. Drifting deep for Tennessee goes Eddie Brown and Dan Golden, who this year, Don Golden it is, has been averaging 38.9 on the punt, will be getting his punter back there to set up a wall, a beginning wall for Brown. The snap, the punt is away. It's a wobbly punt angling to the near sideline and goes out of bounds. Upfield somewhere. Let's see where they mark the ball. It will be in the vicinity of the 40-yard line. So Tennessee's decision, Bill Anderson, to take the wind has perhaps given Tennessee good initial field position.
Well, John, they have excellent position right now on their own 40-yard line with the wind to their back. And so as it's worked out, it's been a good decision. However, Georgia had the first down made there, and Andy Johnson threw a perfect strike. The boy just, he dropped it. Bissell dropped it right in his hands in a little flare pass.
Holloway, the quarterback. The fullback will be Bill Rutter for Tennessee. As Tennessee does a little shifting, but I think they lined up wrong rather than shifting. Holloway gives it to Standback. Standback to the 40, to the 45, to the 46-yard line. He's tackled there by Tommy Smoke, the defensive left end. Here's that defensive line for you as Georgia uses a five-man front. Smoke at 193, Bruce at 224, Cagle at 235, Hester at 217, and Jones at 225. Wide left for Tennessee, Emmett Love. They're shifting that tight end back one way or the other. So that was indeed a shift the last time, rather than lining up wrong. Quarterback Holloway, second down four. Rutter goes from the first down to the 50, past the 50, running straight at Georgia, down to the Georgia 45 and on to the 44-yard line. Finally, wrestled down by Steve Sleek, a linebacker. Big block thrown by Galen Hill of Tennessee. The forward wall for Tennessee across the middle. Inside there is Killian Hill, Urebeck, Emmendorfer, and Schaefer. Tennessee first down, 10 to go at the Georgia 44-yard line. They shift the tight end to Tennessee. Fullback Rutter, tailback Standback. Long count Holloway. Handoff Rutter. Rutter over left guard. Gets a little wedge. Has the ball from the 43-yard line of Georgia to the 42, to under the 40, and beyond to the 39-yard line of the Bulldogs. on the tackle. Bill Anderson, Tennessee, is running straight at Georgia.
They've done that, John, and it appears to be, from what we've seen just in this first series, that Tennessee's offensive line might be a little bit stronger than the defensive line of Georgia.
Tennessee has the ball, second down and 5 yards. So Rudder again, over the left side of the line, up the middle. He has the ball at the Georgia 35-yard line. There is a scramble for what might have been a fumble, but it would have occurred, I think, after the whistle had sounded, if indeed there was a fumble. Georgia indicated it had recovered it. The ball was moved by Bill Rudder over left guard down to the 34-yard Young to a tight end right. Quarterback is Holloway. Tailback is Standback. Holloway looking over the defense, gives it to Rudder up the middle. He is stopped momentarily at the line of scrimmage. Spins off for maybe a yard from the 34 to the 33. And he was stopped there by David McKnight and once again Steve Sleek. He's doing quite a job as a linebacker for the Bulldogs. The ball will be spotted at the Georgia 31-yard line, actually, so that Rudder picked up more yardage than it originally appeared as he was shoved backwards. He has carried the ball four times for 22 yards. Tennessee has its second down 7 at the Georgia 31-yard line. They shift the tight end to the right side again. Holloway looking, keeping, pitching, stand back. Just outside at the 35, 30, inside the 30, down to the 26-yard line. Forced out of bounds by the free safety, Jerome Jackson. The block was thrown by the fullback, Rudder. To the outside went Standback. Let's see where they spot the ball. They bring it in. They're lining it up. Inside the 30, as we mentioned, at the 26-yard line. It will be 2 yards short of a first for Tennessee. It will be third down 2, Tennessee, at the Georgia 26-yard line. No score first quarter. Tennessee power eye right. Terry Moore is in there for blocking. Gives Standback. Fighting for the first down. Does he have it? Yes, he has it. As he rams his way past the 20-yard line onto the Georgia 19. Tommy Smoke makes the tackle. Dick Kahn helps out. But the block up front by Emmendorfer and Schaefer on the strong side and also by Terry Moore. Wide left is Love. Tennessee has kept the ball on the ground. Holloway gives it off to Rudder. Rudder up the middle. It stood up. He got a yard. The Georgia adjusting to Tennessee's power game in the middle. Stops it short this time. Jim Cagle was there defensively. Let's see where the ball is moved. From the 20, 19 and a half, forward it goes to the 17 for a gain of 2. It will be second down at 8 yards to go. Tennessee began this drive at one first down, then punished. Tennessee deep in Tennessee's forward wall move. Holloway will keep and is caught from behind and spun down for no gain. The right side of the Tennessee line jumped off sides apparently, but Holloway was caught from behind by McKnight, so that Georgia has a decision as to whether they want to take the play, which was a loss of a yard, or a penalty. It is a backfield in motion call against man front. Linebackers up close. Holloway, the quarterback. On a draw, gives it over here to the fullback, who is Standback, and he is thrown for a loss back to the 21-yard line. The linebackers were blitzing all the way, and on the draw, they played it brilliantly, and so Standback is thrown for a loss back to the 21. Ricky Townsend coming into the game for Tennessee with 7:55 to go. Georgia's defense rises to the occasion, stops Tennessee's drive, and Townsend will be attempting a field goal from the 28-yard line, a 38-yard attempt by the Dalton Georgia Navy. Snap down, kick is up. Townsend kick is no good, off to the right. There's time out on the field with a by Fulham, but great second effort by Bissell, the tailback, playing for the injured Pullet, got the first down. So Georgia has its first and 10, a football length past the 30-yard line. They began this series at the 20 after Tennessee's missed field goal attempt. Nothing to nothing to score. Bissell and Honeycutt, the running backs, in the eye. Wide out to the left side comes Harper. Quarterback is Johnson. Johnson is fading to throw. Johnson is waiting. Johnson is throwing deep. Long gone downfield. The Putnell is batted down incomplete at the 25-yard line of Tennessee by the covering David Allen, a native of Athens, Georgia. as Johnson threw that ball 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 to 54 yards, and Allen flicked it out of the grasp of the intended receiver, Putnell, who had half a step on him, Bill.
Well, I think that's what's gotten a lot of respect for Andy Johnson. He's got a tremendous arm as well as being a good runner. Johnny was throwing into a pretty brisk wind, too, when he let that ball fly.
It will become second down and 10 to go. And Honeycutt still your running back. Wide to the left side comes Putnell again. Johnson gives the ball over to Bissell. Bissell traps through one tackle at the 30, moves the ball to the 33, to the 34, forward to the 35-yard line. He is tackled as he gets to the 35 by Witherspoon and Pulliam. Ball at the 35. It's a gain of 5 yards on the play, making it third and five, Georgia. The Bulldogs came out and threw the long bomb on first down, so now they're faced with third down and five. Bissell has carried the ball six times for 20 yards for the Dogs. They split the running back for the first time this far in the game. Pitch goes wide. You move in the line, Georgia. Georgia with the ball. Bissell gets the pitch, sweeping wide to the right side, to the 35, to the 36, on to the 37-yard line, where Ken Lambert, the defensive left end, and Carl Witherspoon, the trailing middle linebacker, make the tackle. But it appeared to me that the Georgia right side of the line might have moved before the snap was made. It is short of a first down by a yard and a half. It will be fourth down, a yard and a half to go, or, and Tennessee will decline the penalty. So coming into the ballgame is Golden, marked far away from you on the far side of the field, the north side of the field. Snap to Golden. Hunt is away. Hits it well, a beautiful spiral. Brown, under the ball at the 22, makes the catch, gets the ball to the 25, 30. 35, knocked down at the 37-yard line is Eddie Brown. Tennessee will have the ball at that point. Downfield covering for Georgia was Lynn Honeycutt. The punt was good for 38. The return is good for 9 yards by Eddie Brown. Tennessee gets the ball for the second time in the game. The first time, the ball counted off about 7 minutes of the clock and moved the ball from the 40 down to a field goal attempt of 38 yards, which was wide to the right. The fullback is Rutter. The tailback is Standback. The quarterback is Holloway. The tight end shifting to the right side is Sonny Lee. Wide right, Howard. Wide left, Emmon Love. Tennessee first down 10. Holloway. Standback gets the give, comes straight up the middle over right guard, moves the ball from the 36-yard line to the 38, on to the 39. He was tackled by George Kilcher, the linebacker on the left side, and Dan Jones, the middle guard, was also there on the stop. Moving the ball from the 37-yard line to the 39, it will be second down and 8 yards to go. A short eight. Wide end or strong side to the wide side of the field away from you. No score, first quarter. Rutter the fullback, Standback the tailback, Holloway the quarterback, Holloway keeping, got a pitch to Standback, getting to the corner, 40, 45, gets outside to the 47-yard line, where the cornerback on the far side, Larry West, makes the tackle on him. It may be short of a first down at the 47, they may line it up and see. No, he's got a first. It looks like from here, they finally spotted at the 48-yard line of Tennessee, and it is first down and 10 to go for the Volunteers. So Standback sweeps the side as they froze the linebackers with the fake to Rutter. Then Holloway pitched the ball to the trailing Standback, who has carried the ball five times for 30 yards. First and 10, Tennessee. No score, first quarter. Georgia with a five-man front. Linebackers right up tight. Holloway, fake, spinning out to the right side. Looking, throwing downfield. Pass overthrow. Intended for Chip Howard at the 35-yard line of Georgia. Holloway, fake, and throws everybody for just an instant. Then he spun out right, thought about running. Howard curled back upfield, and Holloway aimed his pass for him but overthrew it. So Tennessee, for the first time, throws on first down. It becomes second down 10. Tennessee sets a slot right, shifting back to the right side. Wide right is Howard. Second down 10, Tennessee. Fullback is Rutter. Tailback is Standback. Fake to Rutter. Holloway pitches the Standback, needs a block, gets to the 50, down to the 45, lowers his head and booms through to the 43-yard line of the Georgia Bulldogs. He boomed through George Kilcher, the linebacker. It was Jerome Jackson who gets credit for the tackle. Ball moved to the 43-yard line of Georgia by Haskell. Standback going wide. Tennessee getting a couple of substitutions into the lineup. And perhaps tearing up the telephone wire from the coach's box in the press box at the same time. It'll be third down, a good 2 yards to go for Tennessee. clock is important. Tennessee on a quick count gives the ball to Sandbeck up the middle. Sandbeck breaks through from 1 minute to the 35-yard line. 45-yard line, down to the 40, down to the 35, down to the 33-yard line goes Haskell Sandbeck. The block on that counter left was by Galen Hill. The tackle was made, who is now Young, to the left side or wide side of the field. Fullback stays rudder. This is Holloway, keeping, cutting up field, breaks away from one man, slides past the 30-yard line of Georgia, diving it forward to the Georgia 28. Jones and Silcher tackle the sophomore from Huntsville, Alabama, at that point. This series began at the 33-yard line. The ball is now down to the 28. Tennessee keeping it on the ground and keeping it inside, with the exception of two occasions when Sandbach has circumvented the wide over left tackle. Tennessee second down five at the Georgia 28-yard line. Holloway looks over the defense, gives it to Rudder. Rudder up the middle, spins off one tackle at the 25 and twirls forward to the 24 and a shade beyond. Tommy Spoke there on the tackle for Georgia. Tennessee continues to run right at them, and it is close to being a first down. They may measure 3-yard line of Georgia. In the eye, power side left, quarterback Holloway. Holloway keeping, pitching to Sandbeck to the corner at the 20, cuts inside to the 15, runs through a man to the 13-yard line. Tennessee goes wide with Sandbeck on a great pitch from Holloway after, again, a brilliant fake to Rudder, freezing the linebackers and also Spoke the end. Trailing up to make the tackle was Rosenberg. The ball is moved down to the 11-yard line of Georgia. It will be for 61 yards in the game. Tennessee shifts to the right with the tight end coming to the wide side of the field. Carruthers is in there at tailback for Sandbeck. This is Holloway, pitching to Carruthers, coming wide right, tries to get outside. He is hemmed in at the 14-yard line and thrown for a loss. Back at the 14 by a crashing cornerback who came up to make the stop, Dick Kahn. Dick Kahn, the cornerback, came up to catch and make the stop on Paul Carruthers, who had come in at tailback, tried to get wide. For an instant, it looked like Tennessee had the interference in front for him to turn the corner and gain good yardage. But fighting through that interference was Kahn with an excellent defensive play at the 14-yard line. This is Holloway back to throw. Here comes the flip. Holloway under pressure. Holloway pitching downfield, completed the 10, down to the 5, down to the 3-yard line. Fights the interior receiver, who was Bill Rudder, the fullback. Rudder makes the catch at the 10, runs through a man at the 5, and fights his way forward. We'll wait till they spot the ball at the hash mark. It appeared to me to be at the 3-yard line. That's where it's going to be. Tennessee is short of a first by 2, of a touchdown by 3. Dick Kahn and Larry West made the tackle for Georgia. Holloway, under pressure from the rear, dropped the pass out into the left as the first quarter comes to a close. That's the end of the first quarter with the score. Tennessee nothing, Georgia nothing. Moore and Rudder are in there. Tennessee moves. The handoff goes to Sandbeck up the middle, fighting his way forward to about the 1-yard line. But Tennessee's left side jumps as they got the play in motion. There will be a decision. Georgia should, of course, refuse the penalty, and it will become fourth down and less than a yard to go. But they're going to take the penalty, and it will bring it back out to the 7-yard line. Tennessee's left side jump. So once again, as has been true so often this year, we remember back to the Georgia Tech game. Quarterback is Holloway. Holloway sprinting out to the right, looking, waiting. Holloway passing out to the 10, taken by Rudder. It's the 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 7, 6. Touchdown, big arm. Bill Rudder rifles in the score for Tennessee. And really, it could have been a blessing in disguise. We almost said it, because Georgia had punched it up so strongly in there to stop Tennessee's thrust deep inside the 5. And Tennessee's fullback has been open on that play time after time. Holloway, with a great fake right, dropped it on a little pass out into the flat to Rudder, who just barreled his way through to score. Holding will be Holloway. The extra point is up. The kick is good. There's time out on the field with a score. Tennessee 7, Georgia nothing. As Gordon said, it leaves a big area for the fullback to go out like he's going to block and just slip out into the flat, and he's wide open in there. Here's Bouncy kicking off into a wind, and it's a spiral. It will be taken at the 7-yard line by Georgia. Back to the 10, to the 15. He slips and falls as he gets to the 22-yard line. Gets up and tries to run again. That was Steve White, the tailback, who brought the ball back upfield to the 22. Georgia now with the wind behind it. A return of 22 yards on the kickoff out to, well, mark it at the 23. Side goes David Christensen, who's in there as a split receiver. Honeycutt the fullback. The tailback is Bissell. The quarterback is Johnson. Johnson keeping coming left. Cuts up field to the 25, and that's all. He sends his flanker to the close side. Hash marks toward you, and the split receiver is out this way. Johnson gives it to the tailback. Bissell comes up the middle. Bissell at the 30. Bissell past the 30 to the 33 to the 34. He's got a first down. Tim Towns and Jamie Rotella make the stop, but Bissell, who is a junior from Birmingham, Alabama, on what I would term a sprint draw. They just sort of turn around, give the ball to him, and he runs Bill Anderson for daylight.
Yeah, he made a real nice move. He started like he was going to go just about off his right guard, and then he made a cut to the outside.
First down, 10, Georgia, trailing 7-0. Johnson looks over the defense, gives it over to Bissell. Bissell is submarined and thrown at the line of scrimmage, maybe a shade behind, by Jamie Rotella, the strong side linebacker, who smelled the play and came blitzing through to upend him for a loss of a yard. From the 33.5 back to the 32.5 yard line. Second down, 11 to go. Bissell has carried the ball 9 times for 30 yards thus far for the Georgia Bulldogs. Second down long for Georgia. Tennessee rotates to the left side. Splitting out is Christensen. Johnson looks over the defense. Gives it over to Bissell. Coming to the left. Bissell fights as he runs into Conrad Graham, who comes up to cover him perfectly. Got past the 35 and moved the ball to the 36 or 7-yard line. Mark it at the 37, where Conrad Graham, who has the pressure first of containing the split receiver Christensen, then, after letting him go on to the safety who picked him up town, Graham came up to fight off the interference and make the tackle on Bissell after a gain of 4, making it 3rd down and 7 yards to go. One cut. Splitting to the right side is Christensen. The running backs are also split. Johnson, back to throw. Waiting. Good protection. Now beginning to break down. Now he's looking. Now he's running 35. He gets to the 40 and has run out of bounds at that point, short of the first down. Tennessee had a lot of people back in pass coverage, and Johnson had plenty of time to throw, but then as the pass protection began to break down, Pulliam and Simonson began to get close to him. He circled out to the right side and got up short of the 40-yard line and short of the first by 4.5 yards. Running with the wind will be Don Golden. Deep for Tennessee goes Eddie Brown. The Vols lead 7-0 over Georgia at Athens. Snap to Golden. Golden front with the wind in the air, and he hangs it high and drills it deep. Brown, trailing to the far sideline, makes the catch at the 20. Looks for the wall. Gets there to the 22, to the 25. He is then powered down to the ground at the 25-yard line. There's time out of the field to score. Tennessee 7, Georgia nothing.
A group of specialists working together as a team. That describes a modern coaching staff and a modern full-service bank like Third National. Each of the Third's 23 offices is staffed with experts in every phase of banking.
First down and 10 to go at the 25-yard line. The give for Tennessee is to the fullback. Straight up the middle comes Terry Moore, the freshman who's in there at fullback. And he didn't get much, maybe a yard. Giving 2 to the 27-yard line. Milton Bruce was waiting on him with Steve Sleet. Terry Moore is a freshman from Clinton. Steve Chansey, Tennessee's starting fullback, has been playing hurt ever since the Georgia Tech game. He has not yet gotten into this contest. Been playing with an injured ankle. He's a great competitor. Tennessee, second down long. Second down about 8 yards to go. Holloway on the keep. Got to pitch the ball to Standback, coming wide to the 30, to the 35, to the 40, to the 41, to the 42-yard line. Comes Canaveral, North Carolina's Haskell Standback, who gets to the corner, then lowers his head and booms for the first down for Tennessee to the Volunteer 42-yard line. Jerome Jackson makes the tackle. Standback did not play last week against Hawaii. Against Alabama, he had 133 yards rushing. To the line of scrimmage, Tennessee, with Standback now having carried the ball 9 times for 76 yards. Tight end shifts right, Young, to the wide side of the field. Holloway may throw. Sprinting out to the right side. Pass downfield is almost intercepted and should have been. He intended his pass for Emin Love. It was batted down by Gene Swinford, who had his hands on a clear interception at the 35, 45-yard line of Georgia. As it is, the pass is incomplete, and it becomes second down and 10 yards to go for Tennessee. Ball resting at the Volunteer 42-yard line. The Vols lead 7-0. Tennessee 7, Georgia nothing. Young tight end shifts right. Tennessee in the eye, run of the fullback, only a yard behind Holloway. Stand back to tailback. Long count by Holloway. Give Rutter. Rutter over the left side of the line. Spins off one tackle at the 43. Pass to Tennessee 45. And bolts his way forward to the 47, maybe the 48-yard line. Fleet was there to make the tackle. I said Rutter. I meant Moore. Terry Moore, the fullback, is in there. And it is he rather than Rutter who carried the ball. Tennessee wearing white jerseys with orange numerals, trimmed in black. Difficult to see. The line of scrimmage comes Tennessee on third down, 4.5 yards to go. Running back split. Here's Holloway. Going to drop it out into the flat to stand back. Makes the catch to the 45. Up the field to the 47 to the 48, and he's thrown at that point. Then there is a marker down at the 48-yard line of Georgia. Tackle was made by Cagle and McKnight on the stand back as Holloway squared it out into the flat to the spreading out stand back. And stand back unable to break free on the screen. Downfield, Tennessee might have been called for shoving or pushing. That's the indication from the field judge, Scobie. But we'll wait and see as the marker was dropped. The ball is called for. Tennessee on the play was guilty of... Well, all we got was the fact that they didn't accept the penalty. So... It becomes fourth down, and Tennessee has Quabo in the punt against the wind. There was a marker down on the play. Some discussion. Georgia declines whatever the penalty was. Deep is Kahn. Snap to Quabo. His punt is away. End over end. Called for and made a fair catch at the 21-yard line by Georgia. White is the man who makes the fair catch. The 31-yard punt into the wind. Georgia has the ball at its own 21-yard line, trailing 7-0. Tennessee 7, Georgia nothing. Georgia has put the ball in play at its own 20, now at the 25, and now at the 20. 21. Georgia at the 21-yard line in Bulldog territory. Tennessee leads 7-0. Johnson with a twin set wide right. Looks over the defense, a five-man front. Johnson keeps on a quarterback draw, fights his way to the 25-yard line, wraps up at that point by Rotella and Witherspoon. Gain of 4, second down 6. Georgia at its own 25. Tennessee 7, Georgia nothing. The Vols have used in the backfield Carruthers at a tailback along with standback, Moore and Rutter, the fullback. Honeycutt and Bissell, the running back for Georgia on second down 6 in its own territory. Tennessee feigning a blitz. The give goes to Bissell. Bissell, you are hung up and dropped to the 25-yard line. On the corner over there might have been Witherspoon or Rotella, the linebacker who got outside. But Tennessee smelled the play, and it was David Campbell, the Nashville junior, defensively in at an end, who makes the stop. Ball at the 25-yard line. It'll be third down, 6 to go. Bissell has carried the ball 11 times for 34 yards. Wide out to the right side comes Christensen for Georgia. Johnson rolling out this way to throw. He's looking. He's waiting. He's throwing downfield. Incomplete. It was intended for Ross Burns, the tight end who sort of slid underneath the deep racing Christensen. He was covered by 10 pounds, and the pass is incomplete. Fourth down 6. Into the game comes Golden. Deep for Tennessee goes Brown. Tennessee leads by a score of 7-0 with 8:51 left to go in the first half of this game. Golden punting for Georgia. Thus far has punted out of bounds for 25, the other time for 41 with the wind. He's punting again with the breeze. The punt is away, and it's a high spiral, driving Brown deep, all the way back to his 19-yard line, to the 20, 25, sends outside to the 30, up to the 32, fighting his way to the 34-yard line. Sheer effort by Eddie Brown, finally forced out of bounds by Honeycutt. We'll wait till they spot it. And a marker might have been dropped over there in the melee. The ball is spotted at the 33-and-a-half-yard line. could have been a clip against Tennessee, and that's what it's going to be. Tennessee battling on a great return by Brown, guilty of an infraction at the point of the tackle, so that a 15-yard step-off is sent against the Volunteers, and the penalty is four, as we guess, clipping. Tennessee has its poorest field position of the day, back downfield at the 17-yard line. Tennessee against the wind, leading 7-0. Moore and Carruthers, the running back. Tight end Sonny Leach shifts to the left side. Holloway at quarterback. Georgia with a five-man front, trailing 7-0. Holloway, keeping, cutting upfield. He is wrapped up after gaining a yard or two. Got the ball from the 17 to the 19, and Steve Sweet makes the tackle on Condrick Holloway. The score, 7-0. The time, 8:20 to go in the first half of the game. Tennessee leading by 7 points, deep in its own territory, after a in fraction against Tennessee. Holloway in the I formation with the tailback Carruthers. Wide left comes Emin Love. Holloway goes to the opposite side, pitches to Carruthers. Carruthers turns upfield to the 20, to the 25, to the 30, to the 35, to the 40, 45, 50, 45, 40, 35, 30, 25, out of bounds at the 25-yard line from Lafayette, Georgia. Street, Paul Carruthers. Caught finally downfield by Larry West, but it was Carruthers who got to the corner and says thanks to Chip Howard of Knoxville for the block on the corner that frees the sophomore, who turns on the speed and gallops downfield 56 yards to the Georgia 25-yard line. Tennessee has its first and 10 at the Georgia 25. 56-yard scamper along the far side boundary to the left side. Howard splits wide out to the left. Holloway with the football at quarterback for Tennessee. Spinning out to the left, faking. He's going to throw. He's going to be hemmed in. He's going to be thrown for a loss at the 28-yard line. He was looking downfield for his tight end, Young, who was covered downfield by Dick Kahn. Deeper went Holloway. Went Howard. Howard was covered by Swinford. And Holloway was tackled by Spoke for a loss back to the 28-yard line. It becomes second down and 13 yards to go. The tailback, Tennessee, sets a flat right. First time we've seen this set, second down long. This is Holloway pitching to stand back. He reaches out to get the ball at the 30, and then he is dropped at the 28-yard line. Great defensive play on the corner by George Pilcher. That was the play on which Carruthers went 56 yards, but this time, Pilcher was not to be denied, and he makes the tackle actually for a loss of a yard. Back to the 29-yard line, where it becomes third and 13, Tennessee at Georgia's 29, with the Vols leading 7-0, and with 6:40 left to go in the first half of the game. Squatting left is Howard inside of Emin Love. The running backs are split. Back to throw is Holloway on a quick count across the middle, complete. Down to the 20, down to the 15-yard line goes Jimmy Young. He is short, I think, of a first down by less than a yard. They will spot it at the 15, and it is short of a first down by about 6 inches. Tennessee may talk about it. We'll see. The Vols may want a timeout. Tennessee coming in with a full house backfield. The Vols have a touchdown. The Vols at the 15-yard line. Georgia stacks it up with an eight-man front. Handoff goes Holloway. Rather to stand back. He falls over the right side of the line. He has a first down as he battles his way down to the Georgia 13-yard strike. First and 10, Tennessee, as the Vols decide to forego the field goal into the wind and give instead to the catapulting standback who moves the ball to the 13-yard strike. Tennessee first and 10 at the Georgia 13-0. Fullback is Rudder. Tailback is standback. Quarterback is Holloway. Wide left is Howard. Wide right, that's Emin Love. Holloway looks over a five-man front. He's going to spin out to the left. He's going to wait. He's going to throw the ball into the end zone. Touchdown, Tennessee, to the tight end, Sonny Leach. Great pattern by Leach. Great throw by Holloway, as Holloway just parks the ball to the tight end, Sonny Leach.
John, I don't know. There must have been a mix-up in the secondary for Georgia, because Leach came straight off the line and ran it. That little hook pattern there, and he was all alone from the time he came off of the ball. There was nobody with him all the way. Of course, the big thing that set the score up was the big run by Carruthers on the pitch, and that's been an awfully big play for the Volunteer offense in the first half here.
Holloway will hold for Townsend's conversion attempt. It's down. The kick is up. The kick by Townsend is good. There's time out of the field with the score, Tennessee 14, Georgia nothing.
Just as the coach
kicking off, Horace King deep for Georgia, along with Steve White. Here comes Townsend, and here's the kick into the wind. It's a wobbly one. It will be taken on a bounce, rolling into the end zone. You better down the ball. He finally does in the end zone. King let the ball roll, and for an instant, Bill Anderson, it reminded me of a Tennessee game of some years past that you may recall.
I recall it very well, John. I let it lay there, and of course, that's a live football. If Tennessee can get on it, they've got 7 points. I think if somebody had on the sideline had started hollering at him, he might have let it lay there.
Georgia has the ball. First down at 10 to go at its own 20-yard line. The Georgia Bulldogs have put the ball in play four times. At the 20, at the 20, at the 22, at the 21, now at the 20. Honeycutt and Poulos. Jimmy Poulos is in there at tailback. There's the gift to Poulos. Breaking to the outside. He's in trouble as he tries to get to the corner. Breaks the tackle and then slips and falls. He's a football player. Playing hurt, Jimmy Poulos. He was initially slowed by Johnson, then David Allen, the Athens, Georgia native, who is injured on the play and leaves the field on the far side, came up to make the tackle on him. But David Allen, playing before the home folks, was injured and has left the game. Let's see if somebody's come on to replace him. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, Danny Jeffries is in there playing the right corner. Honeycutt the fullback. Tennessee leads 14 to nothing. The tailback is Poulos, standing 8 yards deep. The give is to Poulos, cutting back across the grain to the inside. He is stopped at the 22-yard line. Poulos playing something like Henley of Auburn, deep. He was about 8 yards deep that time. And Johnson, the quarterback, spins, gives the ball to him, and then Poulos just sort of picks out where he sees a little daylight. That time he cuts back across the grain to the near side, but he was wrapped up at the 22-yard line by Ken Lambert and Mike Mormon, a defensive tackle who's in there for the Volunteers. Third down, 8, Georgia. Tennessee leads 14 to nothing. Georgia with the ball. Johnson on a fake pass, draw up the middle to the 24-yard line. Tennessee on the play all the way. Alertly, Robert Fulham saw Johnson, who stood as if to pass, then pulled it down on the draw up the middle and got a couple of yards to the 24-yard line. But it will be short of a first, so it's fourth down and 6 yards to go for the Bulldogs of Georgia. Deep for Tennessee, Eddie Brown, the receiver. The Vols lead 14 to nothing. Time, 3:54 left to go in the first half of the game. To our station, if we don't get all the breaks in during this period, we'll get them in the half. Here's the snap. The punt away by Golden. Oh, he bangs that one deep. Brown trailing the ball. It's over his head. It's going to roll all the way down into the end zone, luckily for Tennessee. Quite a break for the Volunteers. The punt is good for only 76 yards by Golden. What a punt. Golden really ran one with the wind, and it was inside the hash mark on the far sideline. Could have gone out of bounds, but it sort of danced along the far sideline into the end zone. So Tennessee has it at the 20, first down at 10 to go, leading by a score of 14 to nothing with 3:36 to go in the first half of the game. Quarterback is Holloway. Moore and, let's see, Carruthers is in there at tailback. Holloway for the Volunteers against a five-man front for Georgia. Looks over the defense. Feeding back a little bit is Jackson. Here's Holloway. He's got to keep. Cuts up field at the 20. Breaks feet to the 25. Up to the 30. He's at the 40. He's at the 45. Slid down at the 43, actually, where he drags his knee. Holloway jitterbugging right and just dancing forward through that opening in the wide side of the field as he fakes the pitch with his head to Carruthers. And he trips up field to the 42-yard line where his knee drags. Fleet and Jackson make the tackle on Holloway, who goes for 22 yards. 3:17, and the clock is running. That's the 12th first down for Tennessee in this game. Georgia has three. Shifting to the left side comes Jimmy Young to tight end for Tennessee. Holloway looks over the defense again, a five-man front. Linebackers up very, very tight. Fake, cross the end, complete down to the midfield stripe and on to the 40. He drags his knee at the 49-yard line. Just a quick slant into the tight end, Jimmy Young. Another play, Bill Anderson, that you, on occasion, as mentioned, has been open.
Now, that tight end has been open, John. Of course, Georgia's defensive ends are playing this option a little bit peculiar. They're getting caught in middle ground. They're not forcing the pitch or playing the quarterback either. They're kind of in the middle, and it's hurting them an awful lot.
second down, a yard and a half to go for Tennessee. The give to the fullback, and cracking up the middle is Terry Moore, a freshman who can run from Clinton, Tennessee. Appears to have a first down inside the Georgia 47. 2:24 to go in the first half of this game. Jim Cagle was there on the tackle for the Bulldogs. Now the official has marked it for the first down, and the clock begins to roll once again. Wide out to the left side for Tennessee comes Stanley Trust, the meteor from Montgomery, Alabama. Wide right, that should be Lassiter probably. Shifting to a tight end left, this is Jimmy Young. Holloway, first down 10 at Georgia 47-yard line. Long count, he's checking off. He's keeping, he cut 45 down to the 43-yard line. Saw the opening and snapped through it for a gain of 4, maybe 5. Dan Jones there on the tackle. In the first quarter, score, Auburn leads Florida 16-0. And to me, that is a surprise. Not that Auburn isn't a great football team. They are a great football team. They're leading 16-0 in the first quarter. Tennessee has the ball here. Second down, 5 yards to go. Holloway will fade the throw. Here comes the pressure. He is going to be dropped behind the line of scrimmage. Back downfield to Tennessee 48-yard line by Dan Spivey. Nobody picked Spivey up, and Holloway never had a chance. He looked up, and that is exactly where he saw Spivey. Let's take 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Ball Network.
Lou Boda's World of Sports every hour, every weekend on WSIX Nashville.
Tennessee leads Georgia 14-0. 1:06 to go in the first half of the game. The Volunteers have it second down and 15 to go. Holloway back to throw again. Here comes the pressure, and he's going to be jumped again. Back downfield this time at the Tennessee 39-yard line. As Holloway just doesn't have a chance. He is swarmed under this time by McKnight as Georgia's defense is just crashing through and powering their way. So Holloway is thrown for yet another loss. And Tennessee on a fourth down. I think a moment ago I said second down, third. It is now fourth down and 24 yards to go. With 35 seconds left to go in the game, time asked for by whom? Timeout asked for by Georgia. With timeout to score, Tennessee 14, Georgia nothing. In the final minute of the first half of the game, exploded downfield. A great run by Foolis. He was tackled with a face mask in traction against Tennessee, adding 15 more. Then a pass from Jack Johnson. Once again with that twin set left. Trailing 14-0, first down, 10 to go at the 20. This is Johnson on a keep right. Turns upfield to the 21, to the 22, on to the 24, up to the 25-yard line. Tackled by Lambert of Tennessee at that point. Johnson, when he rolls out to the right, the guards fall, and he's got four, sometimes five men, it looks to me, in front of him, Bill.
Yeah, of course, he's getting his two backs out there. He's just rolling out behind everybody and turning it up the field. There's an awful lot of interference.
Second down, 5, Georgia at the 25-yard line. The give is to Pulis. Pulis at the 25, at the 26, to the 27-yard line over right guard. Stacked up by Pulliam at that point. It will be short on first by 3 yards, so it becomes third down and tailback. Burns is the wide receiver slotting to the left side. Here is Johnson, back to throw. He's looking for Burns. He's passing to Burns, complete at the 31-yard line. He's immediately decked at that point, but he's got a first. The pass was complete to Burns, the slot man. He was tackled by Town at the 31-yard line, where it will be Georgia's ball, first down and 10 to go. Georgia on a pass out into the flat to the slot man, who cut underneath the wide receiver Putnell. So Johnson has completed the pass. Bissell has replaced Coolidge at tailback. for Georgia. Fullback, he's gone all the way. Quinn set to the wide side right this time for Georgia. Johnson, back to throw. Waiting, looking, being pressured. Got to be dropped for a loss at the 21-yard line. The first pressure was applied by Jamie Rotella, and then it was Eddie Wilson, the weak side linebacker, who came from the backside to make the tackle on Johnson, who almost squirted free. He did free himself of Rotella, but then Wilson was there to make the tackle on him. Back, they say, at the 22, where his forward progress carried him. It will be second down and 19 yards to go. Second and 19. Quinn set wide right. Third down, 19 yards to go, Georgia, at its own 22-yard line. The running backs are split. A slot right. Johnson dropping straight back to throw. Pressure applied. Pass across the middle is incomplete and almost intercepted. It was intended for Christensen. In all honesty, he should have caught the ball at the 45-yard line. But it danced off his outstretched fingertips, and then racing after the tip was Tim Towns, who almost got it, but not quite. So it becomes fourth down, 19 yards to go. Johnson was on
top. Yeah, that was a fine throw in there. If anything, it might have been a little bit high, John, but Christensen was wide open and certainly should have caught the ball.
Back to front now will be Golden. The snap, the punt is away by Golden, end over end. Eddie Brown under the ball at the 35, gets back to the 40. 45 looks for a wall and steps out of bounds as he moves, I think, past midfield, right down below where our view is somewhat screened by the Georgia bench, and the shadows begin also to edge out onto the field at Sanford Stadium. He did indeed return the ball to the 48-yard line of Georgia, so as was true in the first half. When Tennessee elected to take the wind and kick off, the Vols in the first half, as I recall, got the ball at their own 40-yard line. Stand back to tailback. Holloway is the quarterback for Tennessee. He's gone all the way. Holloway coming to the coast side. Keith first to cut, flips and falls after a gain of a yard. From the 48 down to the 47, maybe the 46-yard line. In to pin him was Spivey. Holloway on the year coming into the game and carried the ball 74 times for 187 yards. He had been thrown totally for a loss of 351 yards. Tennessee shifts its tight end to the wide side left. Second down, 9 yards to go, Tennessee. Give Rutter over the left side of the line, and he bowls his way past the 45-yard line of the Bulldogs to the 44. Steve Sleek, the linebacker from Austell, Georgia, is there to make the tackle on him. Duke is leading Georgia Tech now in the third quarter, 20-7. That's at the end of three, at the end of three quarters. And that, of course, is particularly important here to the Georgia fans who follow Georgia Tech also. Tennessee has the ball, third down. It will be 6 yards to go for the ball. Howard slots left. Splitting right comes the tight end, that's Young. Howard is slotted inside of Emmett Love left. Holloway is going to dance out to the left side to throw. He's looking, he's waiting, he's passing. It is incomplete. And send it for Howard, who grabbed it at the 27-yard line, was jolted. The ball popped up out of his grasp. He reached out, got his hands on it again, then lost control at the 27-yard line. So Tennessee is faced with a fourth down six situation, and Neil Clabo, the sophomore from Knoxville, will come into the football game in the third quarter of the game. Holloway was on target, and Howard simply couldn't contain the ball. The snap, Claybo's punt is away. It's a high one, aiming for the end zone. It's got about to the five. It didn't go into the end zone. It's down at the four. That ball hit at the one, I'm sure. Yes. Scobie was right on top of it. And the ball hit at the one-yard line and took a reverse spin back to the four. If this year it goes past the plane of the goal line, it is an automatic touchback. But that ball hit on the one and tipped back out to the four. 40-yard punt. But position was the key. Johnson, the quarterback, deep in his own territory, in the eye. Bissell, the tailback. Johnson rolling out to the left side. Tries to get around the end, cuts upfield to the five, fighting his way out to the 8-yard line. Fine football player, Andy Johnson, sophomore. Rotella and Reynolds there to make the stop on him as Georgia is most intent now on getting the ball out of its own back door. They started this series at the 4-yard line after Claybo's punt hit at the one and kicked back upfield to the four. Johnson now has carried the ball 8 times for 7. Not in there. Bissell is the tailback. Second down, 5 yards to go for Georgia at the 9. Johnson to Bissell. Bissell fighting through to the 10, up to the 11, to the 12. He, I think, is knocked down at about the 12 or 13 yard line. Let's wait till they unsack the Volunteers. Carl Johnson was there first defensively, helping out with Claude Simons in the end from Covington. Where they mark the ball is critical. It will be marked at the 13 yard line. It is short of a first by one. Third down, a yard to go for Georgia. Actually, a little less than a yard. Deep in its own territory with 10 minutes left to go in the third quarter. Tennessee leading 14 to nothing. Big play for the Bulldogs and for the Volunteers. He set it up with a five-man front. Witherspoon, a middle guard. Quarterback is Johnson. He's going to sneak it. He's going to get his first down. He squirts through to the 15, to the 16, to the 18, all the way to the 20-yard line. Comes Andy Johnson for the first down. So Johnson, the junior, who was the sophomore of the year last year, we might have been calling him a sophomore. He's a junior quarterback from Athens. Just took it on himself to battle it out. Bissell, the tailback, the fullback is Honeycutt. This is Johnson giving to Bissell, coming left to the 20, to the 25. Hole opens up to the 30. Up to the 32, fumbles the football out of bounds at the 37-yard line, where it will be Georgia's ball, first down and 10 to go. Eddie Brown scampered over trying to recover the fumble, but it was Bissell coming off the left side, and that's the first time that Georgia's sprint draw has really worked. Bissell is coming out, and Coolidge is in there at tailback. As Georgia begins to move, Tennessee with a four-man defensive front. Johnson with a twin set wide right. Pitches the ball to Coolidge. Coolidge turns. He cuts up field from the 35 to the 40. On to the 41, a bit beyond. He was met as he gets up there by Ken Lambert at the bottom of the heap. David Allen was in there on the tackle also. The ball is spotted at the 42-yard line. A gain of five by Pulis. End of the ball game for Georgia. Comes Harper as a split receiver. The score, Tennessee 14, Georgia nothing. Tailback is Pulis. This is Johnson. He's got a pass out here into the flat. It is caught at the 45-yard line, then stepped out of bounds immediately. Was the tight end who made the catch. That was Lynn Honeycutt, and David Allen is the man who forces him out of bounds, juggling the football at the 45-yard line. So it will be third down, a short 2 yards to go for Georgia, beginning this drive back at his own 4-yard line. And Johnson wedged it out for six. Then it was Bissell, line run. Now they have it at the 45-yard line. Gibb comes to Coolidge, coming wide left, one-on-one. He fights for what appears to be very, very close to a first down. He got to the 46-and-a-half. David Allen in the open field, one-on-one-ing against Coolidge, makes the tackle on him. The officials lining it up to see whether or not it will be a first down, and we may have a measurement to see. Right now, let's take 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Ball Network.
Scoreboard 98 reports all the action.
Very close, five-man front. Johnson, the quarterback. Looking it over, sneaking, fighting. I think he's got a first down as he edges forward to the 48-yard line. It will be first down and 10 to go, Georgia, at the 48. Johnson just leaps it forward behind Big McWhirter and Hammond. And so Georgia has moved this football from its own four out now to the Georgia 48-yard line, picking up the ninth first down. Tennessee lead 14 to nothing. Novak Bissell back in there with his jersey repaired. Andy Johnson has gone all the way at quarterback. He's spinning out to the right to throw. He's being pressured. He's got it up the pass downfield. It is intercepted, I think, or is it incomplete? It's intercepted by Tennessee's diving Art Reynolds. Yay! On a deflection by Allen, I think. It was intended for Honeycutt. Allen tipped the ball, and then Reynolds dived Bill Anderson at least 7 yards to intercept the ball at the high spot.
I don't know whether he's that long or not, John, but that was a tremendous effort on his part because the ball was going away from him, too. He was stretched straight out. That was a great effort.
Tennessee has the ball at its own 46-yard line. First down and 10 to go after the interception by Reynolds. Holloway at quarterback. Long, 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 long count. Fumble. Rolling loosely. Recovered, I think, by Tennessee. Patrick Holloway recovers the bobble. Back downfield at the Volunteer 42-yard line. So it's a loss of 4 yards on the play. Second down and 14 yards to go for Tennessee. The offense not quite as sharp as it was in the first half of the game when Tennessee built a 14-0 advantage. That's the score right now with 7:14 to go in the third quarter of the game. Power eye, but Tennessee will shift. Tight end Sonny Leach comes to the right side, split out by 3 yards. Howard splits by 15. Quarterback is Holloway. Second down long. Holloway dropped behind the line of scrimmage at the 39. Submarining through came the middle guard, who was Milton Bruce. Holloway started to pitch the ball to Standback. He was hit just as he started to do so, and wisely, I think, held on to the football, even though he lost more yardage. Tennessee, third down, and four, well, a loss of three more yards on the play. It's about 17, a little more to go. Third, a little more than 17 to go. Tennessee leading 14 to nothing. Holloway, quick count, back to throw. Looking, waiting. He is covered. Tennessee, and Holloway was dumped for a loss back to the 30-yard line. Bruce, McKnight, Cagle, Jones, all of them in there at the 30. So Tennessee's offense has suddenly been shut off completely by Georgia. And the Vols face 4th and 26 with Quabo in the front. Georgia's got the rush on. Georgia is rushing Quabo. The snap, the punt by Quabo is a high, wobbly spiral. Trail to the far sideline by Conn at the 24. Looks for all back to the near side. Good job back to the 20. Good ball back to the 25. And he's up there and dropped to the 26-yard line. Georgia will have the ball. First down and 10 to go on its own 26 after the 47-yard punt and a 3-yard return. Bill Ritter makes the pass. The Georgia crowd comes to life, standing, cheering as Andy Johnson returns to the game. Tennessee's offense has been shut off completely. The Vols ended up minus 16 on the last series. And now it's Georgia, first down and 10 to go at the 26-yard line. Wide out to the right side, a twin set. That's Harper out there, sliding inside goes Burns. In the I formation, the tailback is Bissell. Quarterback is Johnson. Johnson gives to Bissell. Bissell up the middle to the 30-yard line. Almost. He stops just short of the 30. As there to make the tackle for Tennessee defensively is Art Reynolds, the middle linebacker. The broadcast of today's game is authorized under rights granted to the Edwin C. Husky Company by the University of Tennessee Athletic Department. Any rebroadcast or reuse of this material in whole or in part without the express consent of the Edwin C. Husky Company is prohibited. Georgia has it, second down, 6. Twin set wide right. Johnson coming to the close side. Fighting off there at the end of Johnson. Battle through. Spins off a tackle at the 28. To the 30, to the 33, up to the 35, and it's dropped to the 36-yard line. Very, very close to a first down by Wagster. Johnson was hit 3 or 4 times. He's 198, but he appears to weigh more than that to me. The officials lining it up, and let's see. They signal it is. First down at 10 to go, Georgia. The Georgia offense coming to life in the second half of this game. Johnson has carried the ball 11 times for 32 yards. Georgia has 5 first downs in the second half of this game. Johnson on an inside reverse gives it over to Burns, and Tennessee is waiting on the play. Somebody in the middle saw that counter reverse to the inside coming. John Wagster stood his ground and makes the tackle at the 38-yard line of the Bulldogs. It was a gain of 2. It will be second down and 8 yards to go for Georgia. The score, Tennessee 14, Georgia nothing. In comes Christensen. Out comes Harper at a split receiver for the Bulldogs on second down long. Christensen wide right. The rest of them in tight. Johnson looks over Tennessee's five-man front. Fullback is Honeychuk. Back to throw is Johnson. Johnson being pressured. Johnson throws downfield and it's complete. At the 45-yard line of Georgia. Caught here by Burns, who ran a curl pattern back. He went downfield, turned and came back, and Johnson under pressure released the ball just as he was crushed by Art Reynolds. And it's out to the 45-and-a-half or 46-yard line. It's short of a first by inches. Third down, less than a yard to go for Georgia. How many of these situations Georgia has had in this third period already? 3:59 to go in the third quarter. Tennessee leads 14 to nothing, but Georgia is dominating this game in the second half. Third down short. This is Johnson giving to Bissell. Bissell tries the middle of the line, fumbles the football. Let's see who has it. He might have been down before he fumbled it. Tennessee had the ball, but the whistle indicated that it had been blown dead. And so, let's see where they spot it. The ball is spotted at the 46-yard line. There was a bobble, but it occurred after the whistle had stopped the play. The officials are going to ask for a measurement to see if it'll be a first down. Right up the middle came Bissell as he was hit. and fell to the ground. The ball squirted free. Tennessee pounced on it, but he was already down. So the chains will be stretched, and you'll hear the cheer if it is a first down. Stretched, let's see. It is short of a first down by about a foot. So it's fourth down and a foot to go for Georgia. Earlier in this period, they went for the first down at about the same position. Johnson looking to the sideline. Georgia's going to go for it. They trail 14 to nothing. 3:22 to go in the third quarter of the game. Johnson sneaks on two close plays. Tennessee stacked it up with a seven-man wall up front. Johnson, the quarterback. Johnson pitches the ball to Bissell. Coming wide. Right to the 50. After the 45. Kicked off to the 42-yard line of Tennessee, where it will be first down and 10 to go for Georgia. Tennessee was set for the sweep by Johnson. Instead, he spun and pitched it out to Bissell, and Bissell sweeps wide downfield for Georgia's deepest penetration of the football game to the Volunteer 41-yard line, where the Bulldogs have it first down and 10 to go. Wide right, slot Burns inside of Christensen. The first time Georgia has been in Tennessee. Johnson with the ball. Gives it over to Bissell. Bissell to the 40-yard line, juggling the ball, miraculously holding on to it as he counters forward from the 41 to the 40. But the main thing is he held on to the football. Pulliam and Wilson makes the tackle. It's a different... Stop the quarterback, Sidney Fisher, and hit a great big hole around the end. Second down, 9, Georgia at the Tennessee 40. Johnson rolling to the near side will run to the 40, down to the 38, and as he goes it. He got to the 38, maybe a little beyond. Jamie Rotella and Carl Johnson team up on the tackle at that point. Lambert returns to the game for Tennessee at an end as Johnson on the keeper comes left, moves the ball to the 37.5-yard line. It has to be moved slightly past the 31 for a first. Bissell into the lineup, replacing Coolidge for Georgia. Tennessee 14, Georgia nothing. Inside goes Christensen, double covered. Slot man right is Burns. Third down long. Johnson back to throw. Johnson waiting. The left side opens up. He's running down to the 40, down to the 35, and he carries the ball forward to the 32-yard line. The entire left side of the field opened up, and Johnson scampered out this way. Hurrying up to cover was Danny Jeffries, and then Carl Johnson slid over to help out also. He's short of a first by a yard at the 32. It will be fourth down, one. Fourth down, a yard to go for Georgia. This is the third fourth down situation Georgia has faced, and Georgia wants timeout. With timeout to score, Georgia trailing. Tennessee 14, Georgia nothing. Fourth down a yard at the 32-yard line of Tennessee. Georgia has it. Johnson gets to Bissell. Bissell for the first down. Passing through. Down to the 30. Down to the 25. Down to the Tennessee 20-yard line. It will be first down and 10 to go for Georgia at the Volunteer 20-yard line. Tim Towns and Eddie Brown make the tackle. But once again, Georgia on a short yardage situation goes on the give this time just a straight dive over the left side of the line to Bissell. And Bissell moves it down to the 20. Georgia, first and 10 at the Tennessee 20-yard line. The Vols lead 14 to nothing. Honeycutt and Bissell, the running back. Johnson, the quarterback. Give it to Bissell. Coming to the outside, he stopped for no gain. John Wagster from Campbellsville, Kentucky, was the man who took out the interference. And then coming in to help out on the tackle was Reynolds and Eddie Wilson. No gain. Second down, 10 at the 20. Bissell has carried the ball 19 times for 86 yards. Georgia dominating the third quarter. For Tennessee, stand back 11 carries for 77 yards. Twin set wide right, second down long. Sliding out that way is Burns. Here is Johnson giving it back on a counter to the near side. The Bissell, Bissell at the 20 is slowed, then sweeps outside down to the 18-yard line and is carried down by Reynolds at that point. Helping out was Danny Jeffries. The ball is at the 18-yard line. It's a gain of two, and that's the end of the third quarter. So at the end of three periods, the score, Tennessee 14, Georgia nothing. Johnson up to the line of scrimmage. Wide out to the right side comes Christensen. Honeycutt and Poulos are the running back. Johnson rolling out to the right side will throw. He's looking. He's waiting. He's being pressured. He's throwing the ball into the end zone. Intercepted. Tennessee touchback. Gets the ball to the big arms at the 20-yard line. Intercepted by Conrad Graham, Winston-Salem, North Carolina. Good pressure by Tennessee's defensive forward wall. Johnson thought about running. He should have, because he threw the ball where there was nobody. Ken Lambert is the man who was putting on the pressure. And Johnson's throw, in that case, in all honesty, Bill Anderson, was not a good one.
Well, he had plenty of time, too. John, I think he had an opportunity to look the situation over, except the defender.
Tennessee, which offensively in the third quarter, minus 12. First and 10, 20-yard line, leading 14-0. Holloway, runner over the right side, grinding it out from the 20 to the 22, maybe the 23-yard line. The forward wall for Tennessee, Gene Killian of Tampa, Florida, Galen Hill of Brownsville, Tennessee, Steve Urebeck of Chicago, Bill Emmendorfer of Cleveland, David Schaefer of Oak Ridge, Sonny Leeson, the tight end from Raleigh, North Carolina, now Knoxville, Tennessee, Emmon Love to split in from Oak Ridge. Love will come wide out to the left side. Jimmy Young has come on a tight end for Tennessee. Second down seven at the 23-yard line. Young shifts to the right side where Howard is slotted wide right. Quarterback is Holloway looking over a five-man front on a long count. Holloway, rudder up the middle to the 25 to the 26. He stood up there by the middle of the line. Jim Cagle was there defensively. Milton Bruce there defensively, also for the Georgia Bulldogs. Moving the ball to the 26. It will be 4 yards short of the first down. Third down, four to go for Tennessee. The ball's in the first half. Kept the ball inside much of the time. Went out from the big run was the 56-yard run around the end by Carruthers on the six. Tennessee shifts. It's tied into the wide side of the field. Third down, four at the 26-yard line. The ball's lead 14-0, fourth quarter. Holloway will back, will play the throw. And the pressure comes out of there. Has the ball, the markers down upfield. Holloway to the 25, to the 30, to the 35, to the 37, to the 38, to the 39, and he's tackled. But there is a flag down on the play. Steve Sleek makes the tackle as skittering forward was Holloway for what appeared to be a first down, but downfield a marker was dropped. And the officials are discussing the situation, first with one another. Georgia has not yet sustained a penalty in this game. Tennessee has been penalized three times for 32 yards. The Vols are moving in to discuss the situation. The officials also are looking it over. And here's the penalty. It will be against Tennessee. Penalty is, well, or is it? No, it's going to be against Georgia. He started against Tennessee. No, it's going to be against Georgia. A 15-yard penalty against Georgia. And here it is. That will be an automatic first down. A moment ago, it was wiped off by the penalty. Tennessee shifts its tight end to the wide side right. George in a five-man front stand back. Goes over the right side of the line to the 40, to the 45, to the 50, to the 45, to the 44-yard of Georgia. What stand back turned it out. He is a fine runner. That time, he was running inside in a crowd all the way for the first down, Bill Anderson.
He is really, since the Alabama game, John, this boy seems to have come into his own.
Outside the left tackle, left strong siding it out this way with Howard split. Holloway looks it over. Five-man, seven-man front. Give stand back, left side. Spinning off close to the 41-yard line of Georgia, where he is stopped by Tommy Smoke. The defensive end with help from Sleek again. Sleek played a fine game for the Georgia Bulldog 11. Tennessee 14, Georgia nothing. 12:26 to go in the football game. The ball's led at halftime by a score of 14 to nothing. Sandback has carried the ball 13 times for 95 yards in the game. Rudder 9 for 39. Sandback to tailback. Second down, 6 yards to go for the Volunteers in Georgia territory. Holloway, a little pass, completed a leash at the 35, down to the 30. Leash at the 27. They're wrestling, trying to get the ball away from him. But Leash says no as he makes it to the 27. Holloway, another brilliant fake. He's got such quick hands, and he faked it that time to the fullback, throws everybody, and Leash just ran a little curl, or actually diagonal across the secondary, and Holloway was right on target. Bill Anderson, replay on radio. Tennessee's got a first down, 10 to go at the 27-yard line of the Bulldogs. In the I formation, a little power I set right this time. Holloway, runner over the right side, has the ball at the 25, has the ball at the 20, has the ball at the 15, has the ball at the 10, powers his way down to the 9-yard line of the Georgia Bulldogs. Running with authority this time, rifling his way downfield from Winchester, Tennessee, Bill Rutter.
Some fine running. He ran through several people and carried some folks for about the last 5 yards. They on that play before to the tight end. That has been open almost all. Dumps it over the line of scrimmage to him.
First and goal, Tennessee at the Georgia 9. Holloway the quarterback. Rutter the fullback. Stand back the tailback. They got a pitch. No, Holloway keeps spins and is dropped at the 10-yard line. Almost made it. Holloway, who is so quick, started to dart just before he made the pitch, but McKnight grabbed his jersey, and Golden slid in to help out. A loss of a yard back to the 10. Tennessee 14, Georgia nothing. 10:47 to go in this football game as the Shadows come out onto the field at Sanford Stadium. Wide right goes. That's Howard out that way. Out to the left side, split Emmon Love. Holloway may throw. Rolling out to the right side, being pursued from the rear, and is jumped from the rear. At the 14, fumbles the football, and is recovered by Georgia. Joe McPixton makes the tackle and the recovery. As Holloway from the blind side never saw him coming, fumbled the ball, and Georgia stops Tennessee's drive and takes over. First down and 10 to go at the Bulldogs' 16-yard line. Great pursuit from the backside by Georgia's defense.
Well, we really had several drives by both Tennessee and Georgia. John, it's been on you. They moved the ball. Execution has been real good by both teams. Move it down and get in scoring position, then have a bad, something bad happen to them.
Georgia has it turning 14-0 at the Georgia 16-yard line. First down and 10 to go. This is Johnson spinning to the close side left, turns upfield, has the ball at the 15, to the 20, lowers his head and booms forward to the 22-yard line, where Mike Moorman carries him out of bounds. The clock is stopped with 10:14 to go in the game. Tennessee leading 14-0. The ball will be positioned at the 22-yard line, leaving it 4 yards short of the first. Second down is coming. The backfield for Georgia. Johnson, the quarterback, punish at the fullback. Wide left goes Christensen. Poulos, the tailback. Second down, 4. Johnson, going to give to Poulos. Poulos at the left side of the line is stopped short of the first down at about the 28-yard line by middle guard or middle linebacker Carl Witherspoon. Clock is running. With 9:49 to go, Tennessee leads 14-0. A moment ago, a Georgia drive was stopped on an interception in the end zone by Conrad Graham. And now a Tennessee drive starting to go, closer to 2. Tailback is Poulos. Quarterback is Johnson. Pitch to Poulos, going wide left. He fights for the first down. I think he made it. Past the 26-yard line. Great running on the left side as Tennessee had it contained slightly. Now they pull the ball down and spot it. Where they spot it's going to be critical. A whole host of operatives from both sides surrounding the ball. They spot it at about the 25-yard line. They're going to stretch the chain, and it will be first down and 10 to go, Georgia. Georgia with the ball, trailing 14-0. Tennessee in a four-man front. Johnson gives it over to Bissell. Bissell up the middle is stopped as he moves the ball from the 26 to the 27 onto the 29-yard line, straight up the middle. Carl Johnson is there on the tackle for Tennessee, helping out with Carl Witherspoon. Time is a factor, but there's still plenty of time in this football game. 8:48 left to go. Bissell has carried the ball 22 times for 94 yards. Tennessee leads a twin set wide right on second down 7. Second down 7, Johnson is going to give the ball. No, he's going to fake. He's going to pass downfield. The pass is completed as it's taken by Burns, the slot man right, who makes the catch at the 34 and is fourth out of bounds, close to a first down at the Georgia 36-yard line by 10 pounds. They spot it at the 35, and it appears to be less than a yard short of a first down. They may ask for a measurement. They don't need to. It is not a first down. Third down inches. This has been a game of third down, particularly here in the second on 35-and-a-half-yard line. Johnson, the quarterback. Johnson gives it over to Bissell, fighting for the first down. He has it as he twists off the first tackle over right guard, moving the ball to the 37-yard line. Georgia will have it first down and 10 to go. Tackle made by Jamie Rotella, helped out by Carl Witherspoon. Georgia with the ball at its own 37, trailing 14-0. Christensen out, coming on for him will be Harper. Georgia in the game. Johnson lines it up with his running back split. Bissell right. Johnson fading to throw. Johnson waiting. Johnson looking. He may run out of that pocket. No, he throws it downfield incomplete. It was intended for Putnell, thrown behind him, and the pass is incomplete. Really nobody on top of him. Tennessee had him zone. He would not have been able to go all the way, but had the pass been on target, Bill Anderson, Putnell could have made a reception.
Yeah, John, I was surprised he didn't run with the ball. Of course, he was looking down the field for the receiver, and when you're doing that, it's pretty hard to see how the flow of the defense really gets away to one side. Everything was to the right that time. Had he put the ball down, run with it, he probably could have gone a long ways.
As it is, it's second down 10, Georgia, trailing 14-0. Johnson coming to the close side on a run, turns upfield at the 35 to the 40, and powers his way past the Georgia 40 to the 42-yard line. Ken Lambert and Claude Simonton, who are in there at end. Carl Johnson is playing a tackle now, along with Moorman. Reynolds also there helping out on the tackle as the ball is moved to the 42-yard line, where it will become third down and 5 yards to go for the Bulldogs. Down. Georgia has the ball now with a twin set wide left. Johnson, third down, 5. Stop. Going to wait. Looking. Going to throw a long bomb downfield. The pass is incomplete. Intended for Putnell. Tennessee had Danny Jeffries from Dyersburg playing it all the way. The pass was incomplete, and Johnson took a jolt after he released the football. Fourth down long. Claude Simonton from Covington is the man who tackled him just as he released the ball. Johnson is coming out. Does that mean Golden is in there? With 7:03 to go, Georgia faced with a fourth down long, and Golden is in the punt. Seat for Tennessee is Brown. Plenty of time. Plenty of time in this game. The Vols lead 14-0. The snap, Golden with the win. Gets the punt away. Oh, he drills another beautiful punt. Brown backing up. Watches the ball go sailing into the end zone and on through. And so it will be Tennessee's ball. First down and 10 to go at the 20-yard line. There's time out on the field with the score. Tennessee 14, Georgia nothing.
Do football and driving a car have anything in common? They sure do. On the road,
had the ball. First down and 10 to go at its own 20 following the punt by Golden, which was a mammoth one of 58 yards. Quarterback Holloway on a give, veering over the right side of the line, comes fullback Bill Rutter. Rutter pounds forward from the 20 to the 24-yard line for a 4-yard gain. Chuck Kennebrew is there to make the tackle for Georgia. It will be second down 6 for Tennessee. The Vols lead 14-0 with 6:24 to go in the game. Holloway at quarterback, Rutter the fullback, the tailback is standback. Holloway with the ball, he's got a key. Up to the 25, up to the 30, breaks outside to the 33-yard line. Holloway has the first down. He saw it open up, he dances upfield for the first, and it will be first down 10 to go for Tennessee. He was tackled by Jerome Jackson, but Holloway that time saw the opening and skittered through.
Now, he, of course, he's having a fine day, I think, with execution and all of running the option. He's made some good decisions, and that time he pulled it down just in time and quickly cut right up the field.
Tennessee shifts its tight end to the right side right. First down, 10 to go. The Vols lead 14-0. Holloway gives it to Rutter. Big opening to the right side of the line. Rutter to the 35, Rutter to the 40, Rutter to the 44-yard line, where he's wrestled down at the 45-yard line of the Volunteers. Big hole right side. Schaefer and Emmendorf are blocking for Tennessee. The offensive line, except for that period of the third quarter when Tennessee could do simply nothing offensively, has been coming off of the 73 yards. Tennessee has it first down and 10 to go. First and 10, Tennessee at the 45-yard line. Holloway to stand back. Stand back through the left side of the line. Spins back to the interior as he was saw his hole momentarily shut off, and he walks forward to the 48, close to the 50-yard line. Tommy Spoke and Chuck Kennebrew there. The ball at the Tennessee 48 and 1/2-yard line, starting at the 45, so it's second down and a short 7 yards to go for Tennessee. Ball's breaking from the huddle with 5:15. Holloway sends wide to the left side. The split receiver, Chip Howard. Holloway keeps. He'll go to the 50, to the 45, breaks outside of the 40, downfield to the 35, still on his feet to the 32-yard line is Kendrick Holloway of Tennessee. Blocking out front, who was that? Love and also Haskell Sandback. But it's Kendrick Holloway turning on the speed, turning the corner, and darting downfield to the 31-yard line of the Bulldogs, where Tennessee has the ball, first down and 10 to go. Holloway now has carried the ball for Tennessee's 20th first down play with a 5-man front. Tennessee shifts tight end Jimmy Young left. First and 10, Tennessee at the 31-yard line. Holloway gives it to Rutter. Rutter up the middle, Rutter at the 30. Rutter turns it out to the 25-yard line. He is tackled there by Max Knight of Georgia at the Georgia 25, where Tennessee will have it second down and 4 yards to go. 4:10 left to go in this football game. The Vols with 2 second period touchdowns lead 14-0. Georgia completely dominated the third quarter. Tennessee has come to life in the fourth period offensively. Rutter has carried the ball 13 times for 79 yards. Holloway, 15 for 30. With the ball is the fullback. Rutter over the left side of the line, diving past the 25 to the 23-yard line. Tennessee set at that time not in the eye, but with the running back split. Cagle and Spivey made the tackle on Rutter. He has to move the ball. Tennessee has to move it to the 21 for a first. It's inside the 25 at about the 23 and a half. Running back, runner and left is Howard. Shifting out here is Leach as the tight end. Quarterback is Holloway. Third down, 3.5. Holloway, keeping. He stopped. He will be thrown for a loss at the 25-yard line. Holloway saw the opening, tried to get to it, but it was closed quickly by Steve Sleek, the linebacker. At the 25-yard line, into the ballgame for Tennessee comes Ricky Townsend to attempt the field goal. The score, with 3 minutes to go in the game, Tennessee 14, Georgia nothing. The Vols began this drive at their own 20-yard line. Rudder for four, Holloway for nine, 20. Rudder for six, rudder for one, Holloway minus one. The field goal attempt by Townsend is in the air. The field goal is no good off to the left. There's timeout on the field with a score, Tennessee 14, Georgia nothing.
Remember, friends, even in this age of the superhighway, the going's not always smooth. Once off the main road, the going may be rough with bumps, dirt, dust, and water slides. To the man who wears the Texaco star.
Georgia has the ball first and 10 at the 20-yard line. They're going for the bomb on the first place of scrimmage. It is way downfield, and it is incomplete at the Tennessee 40-yard line. It was intended for David Christensen, and Nick Carmichael, a Georgian, was in there defensively for Tennessee, playing it beautifully all the way. So the Vols, who have used a lot of people again today, have some second-line operatives in there now defensively. Sammy here is an end. He's from Dalton, Georgia. Claude Simonton is there. Mike Mormon, Rob Freer is playing. We'll check the linebacking core for you in just a moment. Georgia has its second down 10 at its own 20. Tennessee has missed two field goals in the game, has moved the ball well in the third quarter, and in the fourth quarter, and in the second period. With the ball, this will be Johnson back to throw. Johnson waiting, trying to get out of the flat, completed the 25 to Honeycutt, the fullback. Honeycutt makes it upfield to the 27-yard line, where he's butted out of bounds by Nick Carmichael, and it will be short of a first by three. Third down upcoming, but the clock is stopped because he was forced out of bounds.
The morning after, get the score from Lou Boda, weekday mornings at 7:40 on WSIX Nashville.
And then Tennessee plays host to Ole Miss homecoming 2 weeks from today. We'll be on at when? 1:30? No, 1 o'clock Eastern Standard Time with the broadcast. Quarterback Johnson, third down short. Johnson rolling out to the right side, going to run. He gets forward, short of a first down, to the 29-yard line. Sammy here turned him inside. And Nick Carmichael, who's making a name for himself in his home state, comes up to plug the gap and make the stop on Johnson at the 29. Clock is running with 2:12 to go, and Georgia fourth down a yard. Now, many short situations they've had, of course they'll be going for it. Or will they? Surely they'll be going for it. Brown is back as if to expect a punt. Now he's coming up to cover. With the ball, quarterback Johnson. Fourth down short. Johnson pitches the ball back here to the tailback, who comes over the 30-yard line and makes his first down. Nick Carmichael again is there on the tackle. And let's see who the Sammy here also helping out. The tackle was made on Poulos, who is in a tailback. And Poulos moves the ball to the 31, where Georgia has its first down and 10 to go. The clock is running with 1:41 to go. 14 to nothing. Tennessee leads Georgia. Tennessee got 2 second quarter touchdowns, and that's been the story. Georgia threatened one time. Tennessee has threatened on two or three occasions. Quarterback is Johnson. He's dropping back in the pocket to throw. He has time. He's throwing the long bomb downfield. It is incomplete. Tennessee had double coverage on the intended receiver, who was Harper, at the Tennessee 35-yard line, dropping back to free safety Watt and also Nick Carmichael. And Gordon Turney also was in there at a corner. Pass is incomplete. Clock is stopped with 1:21 to go at the 31-yard line of the Bulldogs. Tennessee leads 14 to nothing. And we're probably a couple of spots short, so we'll be taking some extra 30-second breaks to our stations along the line to get you caught up on business situations. Back to throw is Johnson. Johnson is being blitzed. Johnson's running out of the pocket. Johnson pumps once, pumps from behind, and is clotheslined down as he races forward to the Georgia 41-yard line for what appears to be a first down. Tennessee in the prevent defense had a lot of people back deep. Johnson got a little pressure on the right side from Campbell, and then ran out of the pocket and skipped downfield to the 41-yard line, where it is indeed first down and 10 to go for Georgia. Johnson has now carried the ball 17 times for 64 yards. He is 5 of 13 for 27 yards in this second half. Johnson will be in a quarterback, dropping back to throw on first down. Pressure applied from the far side. He's waiting. He's pumping the ball downfield. Underthrown, incomplete. Rotella got in the flow. Honeycutt was the man for whom the pass was intended. Pressure from Freer and Campbell, forcing Johnson to rush his pass. Johnson slowly up off the ground. Into the ball game for him comes Ray. And he should get a hand. A courageous football player, Andy Johnson, who is getting released as Ray is on the pass for him. Johnson leaves. Ray is a strong, long thrower. 40 seconds left. Tennessee leads 14 to nothing. Ray to pass. Ray across the middle pass. Drop. Christensen had it at the 48-yard line of Georgia. He was hit just as he got the ball by Tennessee's linebacker, who was Reynolds. But the clock is stopped with 34 seconds to go. Rob Freer put a little pressure on the quarterback, who in this case is James Ray, 6'3", 190 senior, Columbia, South Carolina. Out of the ball game comes Christensen. Coming on to replace him is Bob Burns. Horace King is also in there as a split receiver. Tennessee 14, Georgia nothing. Clock stopped, 34 seconds to go in the game. Ray, back to throw. Here's the pressure. Here's the pass across the middle. Complete. Taken downfield by Burns of Georgia at the Tennessee 44-yard line. Wrestled down immediately by Turney. Georgia has a first down. The ball will be marked. The clock then will be started as soon as it is marked. Georgia lines up without a huddle. They've got 12 men in there now. Bissell comes out. Poulos is in there at tailback. First down, 10 to go, Georgia at the Tennessee 44-yard line. 19 seconds to go. Ray back to pass. Here's the press in the backside. Drops it out of the flat. Complete to King. King at the 40. King at the 35. King down to the Tennessee 34, 33-yard line. It's tackled there by Nick Carmichael. Clock is stopped as it appears to be another first down for Georgia. Tennessee in the prevent defense, willing to give up the short stuff. Not, of course, wanting Georgia to score. The Vols would like a shutout, and right now Georgia is asking for timeout. With timeout, Georgia will have the ball with 8 seconds left to go in the game. First down and 10 to go at the Tennessee 33-yard line. Ray, the quarterback. Tennessee with its defensive secondary, Carmichael, Watt, Turnage, and Jeffries. Ray splits the running back. Poulos and Honeycutt are in there. Wide to the right side comes Harper. Back to throw is Ray. He's looking for Harper. He's throwing the ball deep for Harper down into the end zone. It is batted down incomplete with 1 second to go in the football game. 1 second left to go. It was batted down by Nick Carmichael. Carmichael's done a whale of a job since he came in here, Bill Anderson.
Johnny has, of course, the defensive secondary have all done an excellent job. I think, as you said earlier, they're just in their prevent defense, and they're laying back very deep. The thing they don't want to do is let anybody get behind them. They're willing to give up some of the shorter passes up front, and Georgia's been able to hit a couple of them and move the ball out to where they are now as a result of that.
Tennessee leads 14 to nothing. 1 second left to go on this game. Ray will throw. Ray gets some pressure. Ray throws across the middle. The pass is incomplete as the football game is over. Up and down for the Volunteers. Up and down for the Bulldogs. Tennessee pretty well dominated the first half. Kept Georgia in very, very poor field position throughout the first half of the game. Georgia never crossed a midfield stripe, indeed, until the third quarter, when Georgia made its only really serious threat. And it ended with a pass interception by Tennessee's Conrad Graham in the end zone for the touchback. This is the first time Georgia has been blank since 1969, when Georgia Tech beat them 6-0, and only the second time since 1963, when Auburn beat Georgia 14-0. The Vols win it 14-0 here, and Bill Anderson, your comments first on Tennessee's defensive play.
Well, I think they played an excellent job. And, of course, it shut Georgia out. They're they're a strong offensive team. They got a big, strong offensive line, good running backs, and Andy Johnson, probably one of the best quarterbacks in the conference. And when you can shut the team out, you've done an excellent job. I think the defense has played well all year, John, and they just put in another real good performance this afternoon.
All right, now the Tennessee offense.
Well, as I said earlier, I think they played probably the best first half here. They look better than I've seen them look all year. They seem to have a little trouble in the second half. Of course, Georgia made some adjustments in their defensive took the, tried to take the pitch away or to stand back, and as a result, Holloway here in the second half made some pretty sizable runs by keeping the football and turning up field with it. But it was the big thing offensively, as far as the Vols is concerned, was the option to either side. It didn't seem to make a whole lot of difference. That was a big play for them all afternoon in Georgia. They just wore them out with it, and I felt like, as we said earlier, when before the game started, this was a pretty evenly matched contest, it looked like, on paper. And I think even though the Vols went 14-0, it wasn't a one-sided 14-0. Georgia appeared to be in it right all the way, and very good football team.
With its victory over Georgia here at Sanford Stadium in Athens, Tennessee runs its 1972 record to 6 wins and 2 losses and wins its first Southeastern Conference game. After losing by 4 to Auburn and then to Alabama 17-10, Georgia's record is now 5-3 in the conference. Georgia is 3-2. Statistically, Tennessee had 20 first downs, Georgia had 18. Net rushing, Tennessee 50 carries for 275 yards, Georgia 50 carries for 182 yards. Tennessee in the air, 7 of 10 for 68 yards. No interceptions. Georgia, 8 of 23 with 2 interceptions, totaled 83 yards in the air. Tennessee total offense, 343 yards. Georgia total offense, 265. Tennessee lost one fumble, Georgia none. Georgia was penalized one time for 15 yards, Tennessee 3 for 32. Georgia punted 6 times for 49.5 average. Great punting by Golden, including a 76-yard punt and a 58-yard punt, both of which went into the end zone. Tennessee punted 5 times for 38 yards. Total offensive plays in the game, Georgia 71, Tennessee 63. And it was the third quarter where that big difference, or where the difference came, because in the third quarter, Tennessee had only 6 offensive plays. Individually, Holloway, 16 carries for net 29 yards. He was thrown for a loss of 30 yards. In other words, he lost 30 yards in the game. All told, he gained 59, but net, he gained 29. Standback, 13 carries, 95 yards. Rudder, 14 carries, 80 yards. Steve Chancy did not play in the football game, still hobbled with an ankle. He's been playing hurt, and today they decided, even though he's a courageous young man, not to play him, and he did not play, hoping that he'll be better for the Ole Miss game, which comes up in 2 weeks. Carruthers carried the ball. We don't have his total, but he had the biggest run of the day, a 56-yard sprint down the sideline. He carried it twice for 54. So he gained 56 on one, and he lost 2 on the other. On the other side of the ledger for Georgia, Johnson carried the ball 17 times for 64 yards. Poulos, who was playing hurt with an injured shoulder, 7 for 13. Bissell, 23 for 96. So the Bissell and Standback were the chief ground gainers in the football game. In the passing department, Tennessee's Jimmy Young caught 2 for 23 yards. Rudder caught 2 for 18. One of them a touchdown, and Sonny Leach caught 2 for 27, one of them a touchdown. As Tennessee scored its first touchdown on an 8-yard pass from Holloway to Rudder, the extra point by Townsend was good, and then it was Holloway to Leach for 13 yards. Townsend again kicked the extra point, which makes how many straight? 84, I believe. 84 straight extra points for Tennessee, as the Volunteers win this football game by a score of 14-0. On passes from Holloway to Rudder, and Leach. And the Vols now are 6-2 on the year. Georgia 5-3. Tennessee still has to play against Ole Miss, Kentucky, and Vanderbilt. A rough final 3 games for the Volunteers of Tennessee. We've had a lot of fun sending you the broadcast this afternoon. Our thanks to our crew, who have done another outstanding job in telling us what to say. Our spotter, Steve Bedd. Our statistician on top, as usual, Russ Bedd. Our engineer, Bob Williams, and our producer, Edwin Husker.